Hi guys, so welcome back to this session. So I'm quickly going to discuss about some of the concepts of absorption costing. You must have seen Shagun's video, but even after that video, there are some doubts that people still have. So I wanted to make a short example and show you guys how absorption costing is done. Again, in the interest of time, let's get started quickly and not waste too much time. Great. So firstly, absorption costing, just to summarize it again, in absorption costing, what we do is we take the normal overheads that are there. This is basically even before the actual production starts. Okay, so it's before the production starts, we take the overheads that are estimated and we take budgeted number of units that we think that we are going to produce over the period of time. So for example, let's take 45,000 as the overhead, normal overhead that we think, and let's say 1800 units we will be able to produce. So that gives us overhead rate of 25 rupees per unit. Okay, now all the absorption, like all the production overhead, the fixed production overhead will be absorbed using this rate. This is the normal fixed overhead. The variable overhead part already has a rate that is directly attributable to the each unit, but this is a fixed overhead that is being absorbed at the rate of 25 per unit. Correct. Now let's assume that instead of 1800, the first year we have a actual production of only 400, let's say. So what will happen is, and the actual overhead turns out to be 12,500. What will happen? Actual overhead turns out to be 12,500, but because we are using the absorption costing method, we will absorb the cost using this 25 rate. Now we have manufactured 400 units multiplied by 25, that gives us an absorbed overhead of 10,000, whereas actual overhead is 12,500. So this difference is in this case, it's an under absorption because we have absorbed only 10,000 of the overhead. So this will lead to a treatment of under absorption and we have to add this back. Okay. Similarly, again, if I take another example of, let's say, next quarter, we have 14,000 cost and we are able to produce, let's say, 800 units or let's say 600 units. So in that case, what happens? 6,000 into 25, it's again absorbed at 15,000. Now 15,000 is the absorbed amount and the actual amount that we have incurred during that quarter is 14,000. So see, the prime concept behind this is that before production only, we have determined this 25 rate. We have not started production. This is based on last year or any other estimate by the management. We have determined this rate. Now, as and when the actual overheads are incurred, we are basically absorbing that fixed overhead using this rate and then adjusting for the actual and the variance between the actual and the budgeted. Here, using the overabsorption, here it's under absorption. So we will add this back. Here is over absorption, so we'll reduce it. Okay, so I hope this part is clear. Now I have taken an example from the ICI material to give, because that is the examples on the Huron case study and the Zest one, those are very comprehensive. So I wanted to take an example which is an isolated example of only absorption costing and how that is treated. Okay, so if you guys can quickly read through the question, and I would ask you to pause and try and find out the absorption or under absorption in this case, and I'll get started. Okay, so it says basically the total overhead expenses of a factory is 446,380. This is basically the actual amount of overhead that has been incurred. The management has basically decided to use 1.25 per hour as the absorption rate, and the actual hours were 293,104. Right, so what is my total overhead expenses, which is my actual overhead expenses, is 446,380, correct? Now, if we move ahead to the absorption part, how much will be absorbed? It's equal to 1.25 multiplied by the actual number of hours. So 293,104, correct? Now, you can see 80,000 is the difference between the actual overhead and the absorbed overheads. So this 80,000 leads to an under absorbed overhead, right? Now I've taken an arbitrary example. So fixed production overhead we have taken over here from 446,380. I've also taken fixed selling cost as 153,620. just as an example to show you guys the difference of between the marginal costing method and the absorption costing method. Okay, so these are the two fixed costs. So what happens in marginal costing is that you remember this one, sales minus variable cost equal to contribution, then contribution minus fixed cost equal to profit or loss or break even, whatever. Now in marginal costing, we take all variable costs over there just below the sales, and all fixed cost we take at the actual rate and we minus it from the contribution, right? So if this was the case, this fixed cost, we would have taken the entire fixed cost of 6 lakhs. In marginal costing, we would have taken it here. Okay, after contribution, we would have taken it here. But in absorption costing, what happens is that we don't break it up into a bracket of entirely variable cost and fixed cost. We break it up into production cost and selling and other costs. So within production cost, we take the variable as well as the fixed costs. Okay, now the fixed cost is, you cannot determine the fixed cost per unit. So that is where we use the budgeted units to determine this overhead rate. Okay, and naturally the fixed cost will change a little bit during the year, and that's why there's a difference. Okay, so here in this case, what we had was the total overhead expense of 446. So for example, if I take this over here, so out of this entire 446,380, see, entire 446,380 is my cost. Okay, but we have absorbed only 366,380 over here. So in my absorption costing, when I use the production cost, I will take only fixed production cost absorbed part. Okay, this is only the absorbed part. So only the absorbed part I'm taking over here, and whatever changes there are, whatever difference there are, I'll take it over here as 80,000, this difference. And if you add them together, the total will come to that 446,380. But we are just separating it because while calculating the cost of production, we do not know the what is the actual expenses. So we use the absorption rate to determine the fixed cost that is absorbed to those units. Okay, and later on, before selling, we get to know, okay, this is my actual cost, and then we use the under absorption, over absorption to basically account for that difference. Right, and again, fixed selling expenses, this would come over here. So let me just equal to, so you can see in both cases, my total cost will be 6 lakhs. In marginal cost also, it's 6 lakhs, but in absorption costing, what we are doing is we are separating the fixed portion using that recovery rate or budgeted rate, overhead rate, and the under absorption or over absorption part, we are changing it on the basis of the difference. So this 80,000 difference, we are either, if it's under absorbed, we'll add it back. If it's over absorbed, we'll reduce it. Okay. And fixed selling is over here separately in selling and distribution cost. Whereas in marginal costing, this would have been clubbed because all fixed costs are clubbed in one head over there. And all variable costs, whether production, whether sales, whether anything, those are all clubbed under marginal costing in one head. Okay. So that is thing. Another thing that I just wanted to quickly talk about is some people are getting confused between the absorption. Like there are two sums that sir had done in class. In one, he had added it back once and then again deducted it. And in this case, this is the, I think there were two cases, Huron one and Zest one. So I'm just trying to clarify that in both cases, once it's being deducted and then again it's being added back. Just because of the presentation, it's not being shown that way. So this is the two methods that is being used. So essentially the calculation is the same. Just try to understand this part. What sir has done in that other sum was he had taken first fixed production overhead actual. Okay, so fixed production overhead actual minus absorption over here and then taken fixed overhead applied. Okay, we are here, we are just taking it directly, but sir has broken it down into two steps. And then this part is the same. Okay, sorry, this would be 80,000. Okay, this part is again the same thing. Got it? So just don't get worried about that, why are the two methods very different? It's the same thing, just in this case, it's only one line item. Here it was broken down into three parts. Okay. So I think that's it for the video. I think let me just show you what the impact will be in case the number of hours were actually more than the thing. So let's make this one a little bit more. So let's say 3000 something. So if I had more hours, my absorption, the absorbed expenses would be higher than my actual overhead that was incurred. So in that case, we would have had an over absorption. So if there was an over absorption, how would I have shown that part? So here in my fixed cost, it would remain the same because my fixed cost is not changing. And this is the actual cost. However, in absorption costing, how much would have been absorbed? It would have been absorbed over here, the absorbed expenses. And here in the under absorbed part, how much would have been absorbed? This 45,000 would be reduced because I have already incurred, I've absorbed more than the actual. So I would adjust by reducing that. Okay. And again, if you see the total, it will come to 6 lakhs. Okay. So I hope this part makes it more clearer for you guys. So don't get worried. It's not that complicated. Okay. Just don't confuse yourself. Okay. Watch this video again if you want. And I'm trying to come up with more videos to help you guys with the test.